This is Janet Androvier.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we are going to explain the self-induction phenomenon, give the relation between the self-flux crossing a coil, its inductance, and the current it carries, give the expression of the inductance of a coil in terms of its number of turns N, the area of each turn S, and the length of the coil. Give the expression of the self-induced electromotive force.
Self-induction phenomenon. To understand this phenomenon, let's watch the shown experimental animation and then interpret the observation. This circuit includes an ideal battery, an SPDT switch. This switch has one input terminal and two output terminals, two identical lamps L1 and L2, a resistor, and a coil. L1 and the coil are connected in series, whereas L2 and the resistor are connected in series. Let's start the animation by turning the switch to position 1. When I start the animation, look carefully to compare the brightness of the two lamps. We observe that L2 glows instantly, whereas L1 glows with a certain delay, or the brightness of L1 increases gradually until it finally glows like L2. This graph shows the growth of the current in the coil. It shows that the current starts zero and increases to become maximum at a state called the steady state.
The two lamps glow normally. I want you to focus on the brightness of each lamp when I turn the switch to position 2. Observe. So we observe that L2 dies out instantly, whereas L1 dies out with a certain delay, which means that the brightness of L1 decreases gradually until it finally goes off. We know that the brightness of a lamp is related to the current it carries. So if the brightness of a lamp decreases, then the current it carries decreases. Now look at the graph. The graph shows you the current decay. The current decreases from its maximum value until it finally becomes zero. Now, in this study, the steady state is attained when the current becomes constant. In our case, the current becomes constant when its value becomes zero. So this is the steady state in case of current decay.
Interpretation. In the experimental animation, we observe that L1 glows and dies out with a certain delay. The question now, what happens in the coil that leads to this delay? When the switch in position 1, the current in the coil increases from zero to a certain value I1. And we know that a current in a coil creates a magnetic field. So the magnitude of the magnetic field created by the coil increases. Then the coil is crossed by a variable magnetic flux. And a variable magnetic flux leads to an induced electromotive force E in the coil. According to Lenz's law, the induced electromotive force in the coil tends to oppose the increase in the current. That explains the delay of the brightness of the lamp. Now, when the switch in position 2, the current in the coil now decreases from I1 to 0. So, the magnitude of the magnetic field created by the coil also decreases to 0. Then the coil is crossed by a variable magnetic flux. Similarly, the coil is the seat of an induced electromotive force E. According to Lenz's law, the induced electromotive force tends to oppose the decrease in the current. That explains the delay of the die out of the lamp.
As we have seen in the previous slide, we don't have an external source of magnetic field. Actually, the magnetic flux crossing the coil is due to its own current. This magnetic flux is called the self-flux or the proper flux. Also, the electromotive force induced in the coil due to the variation of the current it carries is called self-induced electromotive force. Now, this phenomenon is called self-induction. Now, what is the definition of self-induction? Self-induction is the induction of an electromotive force in a circuit when the current in that circuit is varied.
Focus, please. This is important.
Inductance of a coil. The self-flux crossing a coil is directly proportional to the current in this coil and is given by this formula. Phi is equal to L times I. In SI, phi is expressed in Weber and I is expressed in Ampere. L is a characteristic property of the coil, which is called the inductance of the coil. The expression of L is shown later in this video. The SI unit of L is the Henry and denoted by the letter H. For a coil without a soft iron core, as shown on this figure, in this case, L remains constant. If a soft iron core is introduced in the coil as shown on the second figure, in this case, the inductance increases and becomes variable with the current. But in this study, we consider coils without a soft iron core, or L remains constant.
Now let's specify the sign of L. Observe figure 1. The current is in the chosen positive sense, so the current is positive. Now, if you curl the fingers of your right hand in the chosen positive sense, your thumb points vertically upwards, which is the direction of the unit vector and perpendicular to the plane of the conducting loop. Now, this means that the magnetic flux crossing the conducting loop due to its current is positive. Let's move to figure 2. Now, in figure 2, the current is opposite to the chosen positive sense, so the current is negative. But the unit vector N is vertical downward, so phi is negative. Now, observe, I is positive and phi is positive. In the second figure, I is negative and phi is negative. This means that I and phi always have the same sign, but phi is equal to L times I. If phi and I have always the same sign, this means that L is a positive quantity. Now, let's move to the role of L and the role of the resistance R. Let's start with L. The inductance L of a coil does not affect the value of the maximum current in a circuit, but it delays its growth and its decay. Then L is a measure of the opposition to a change in current. Let's move to R. The resistance R affects the value of the current in a circuit. With a larger resistance, the circuit carries a smaller current. Then R is a measure of the opposition to the flow of current.
Now, expression of the inductance L of a solenoid. In general, the expression of the magnetic field vector created by a current inside a solenoid is given by this formula. B vector is equal to 4 pi times 10 to the power minus 7 Ni over L times N vector, where the capital N is the number of loops of the solenoid, I is the current in the solenoid, small l is the length of the solenoid, and n vector is a unit vector normal to the plane of each loop, and it depends on a positive sense. Observe the figure. Now, the flux crossing the coil is given by this formula. Phi is equal to nsb scalar n, where s is the area of each loop. So, replace b by its expression, and we know that n scalar n is equal to 1. Therefore, the flux is given by this expression. 4 pi times 10 to the power minus 7 n squared si over L. But the inductance of the solenoid is given by the self-flux over I. Now, I cancels I. Therefore, the inductance of the solenoid is given by 4 pi times 10 to the power minus 7 n squared s over L. But n squared is positive. S is the area of each loop is also positive, and the small l is the length of the solenoid is positive. So this expression shows that again the inductance of a coil is always positive.
Finally, let's move to the expression of the self-induced electromotive force. In previous episodes, we determined the induced electromotive force from Faraday's law, E is equal to minus d phi by dt. Now, in this episode, we study the self-magnetic flux. So, phi is equal to Li. Now, we need to differentiate Li with respect to time. In this study, we deal with coils without soft iron cores. So, L is constant. This is going to be E equal minus L di by dt. Now, look at the expression of E. L is positive. This means that E and the time derivative of the current have opposite signs.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.